Alright, today I'm going to test out a silicone makeup applicator. This is something that has been going around the internet for a little while and I'm really curious to see how this is going to do. It's really intriguing because this is supposed to be a really cool thing you can use to apply your foundation. It supposedly applies it really evenly, it doesn't absorb any makeup, and it's really easy to clean this. So I decided to give it a try and this is what it looks like. This is just a generic silicone applicator. It looks like literally a bra padding, something you would literally find inside your bra, but it's not. I mean, I guess it could be, but I bought it specifically as a makeup applicator. So I'm really curious to see how this is gonna do. I have my dirty beauty blender, so we'll see how these two compare. And the foundation that I'll be using today is called Maybelline Fit Me Foundation. I did a review on it not too long ago, and I'll leave that down below. And without further ado, let me jump in and get started. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna apply this foundation on my finger, and I'm gonna transfer it over on my skin, and then I'm gonna use this silicone applicator to spread the foundation. So I hope you can see what I'm doing. Hope I can see what I'm doing too. So I can already see that it's leaving streaks. This is actually smearing the foundation instead of actually like blending it in. Wow, it's pretty bad, huh? I was hoping this would be so much better than it is. So it does not blend the foundation at all. It literally like smears it. And I mean, it kind of does blend it, like maybe a little bit. But I mean, you can see streaks. Literally, you can see streaks. I am not feeling this at all. This is just literally smearing it. On the bright side though, the applicator has very little foundation on it. It didn't absorb any foundation as expected, so that's a good thing. But on the other hand, it's also doing a pretty bad job of applying foundation. It like literally, like I said, smears it. So it's slipping and sliding everywhere. The foundation is just like, look at that. I mean, I know I applied a little bit more foundation than I typically would. I typically would just dab a little bit, then blend that area out, then dab a little bit more, blend that area out. But nonetheless, like, this is supposed to somehow make it look more natural. Yeah, this is a no-go. I'm already gonna call that. I was hoping that this would be great because it is awesome as far as like not absorbing any foundation. It's really easy to clean it because this is literally silicone, but on the other hand, it's so slippery and so smooth, the surface of this applicator, that it does not transfer the foundation evenly onto your skin. It's just not doing that good of a job at all. So let me go ahead and take my beauty blender and blend it out and see if it can blend this out. The beauty blender, on the other hand, does a much better job of just making your foundation look almost airbrushed. So let me go ahead and do the other side with my beauty blender. You see how nice and even the foundation is being applied with the beauty blender? No streaks, no smears, everything's, it's just applied really evenly. Now on the other hand though, this is how much more product the beauty blender is absorbing. All that orange stuff, that's my foundation that the beauty blender has absorbed, and the little amount of foundation that's on this is pretty much nothing compared to the amount of foundation this is absorbing. It's not that much, I guess. You know, you do fill this with water and then that prevents some of the product from getting in, but clearly there is product on the sponge. There's no doubt about it. It does absorb more than this does. On the other hand though, this actually applies your foundation really nicely, whereas this just smears it. So I would not recommend getting this. I totally do not get the whole hype of the silicone sponge. I mean, it's literally, like you saw, I literally smeared my foundation instead of applying it nicely. And yeah, you don't waste much foundation, but then you end up looking like poop by the end of it. So what's the point? I mean, I would rather waste a little bit of foundation. There's no going around about it. This is wasting it a little bit. And I would rather do that than have my foundation be all smeared, see streaks, and just not having it look good. So let me go ahead and finish the rest of my makeup, and I'll come back and we can finish chatting about the silicone sponge and how upset I am about the fact that it's totally like a weird product that does not do anything, and I'm just so disappointed with it. I'll be right back. I am back with the rest of my makeup, and I'm still feeling a little bit disappointed that this silicone sponge did not perform as well as I hoped it would. And it's an awesome applicator in theory, but then when it actually comes to application of the foundation, it sucks, basically. This is a generic one, this is not a branded one, but it's a silicone sponge, there's really not much to it. So I don't like these. Period. They're just not doing anything for me. You'll always have to do something else with it. You can't just use this and nothing else to apply your foundation. You have to then go ahead and use something else to blend your foundation with, because this is not going to blend anything. It's just not doing a good job of blending at all. As you saw, it literally just smeared it. It's so slippery and so smooth, which actually feels really nice, but it doesn't do a good job of blending the foundation in, unlike the Beauty Blender. The Beauty Blender is great for blending the foundation, and it's great for a lot of different things. On the other hand, the Beauty Blender is a little bit more challenging to take care of. You have to wet it, then you have to let it air dry. You have to replace it more often than you would have to replace something like this. And also, it does absorb more foundation than this one does. In fact, this doesn't absorb any. You know, it's a non-poreless material. This absorbs probably a good amount. Yes, you wet it and stuff, and that prevents some of the absorption from happening, but it does absorb more than nothing. And if you have an expensive foundation, that is something to consider. But if you have an expensive foundation, you don't want it to look smeared. And this is what for me, that's what it did. I'm not saying like that's necessarily gonna do that for you, but for me, it just literally smeared the foundation. I was really hoping this would work, so I'm definitely disappointed. I know everybody has different opinions on different makeup products, because you know, you have different likes, different tastes, different body chemistries, whatever, but I personally do not like this. As you saw, it just literally made my foundation streaky. It was not doing anything for me at all. You may have a different opinion of that, and that's totally fine. This is just my personal opinion, and if you have any questions or comments, leave them down below. I'll be happy to read them and answer them. And if you like this video, give a thumbs up. If you want to see more of my videos, subscribe down below, and I will see you later. Bye.